Sound running when you're ready.
Oh, well, the zoos are very important to animals. They're a bit like homes, like nursing homes, and for poor animals and people like old people. And there's old animals which are dead, and people in the wild don't have much to eat, so they have to kill their own people to have something to eat.
Oh, it's very, very good. Very good. Very comfortable, you know, well looked after, and it's in a nice position.
They try to make you comfortable, they try to put you in a quite nice situation with standard food that look more like a dog food than food proper for wild animals, all right?
Well, most of the cages are a bit small and neither grotty and everything, but the terrapins seem to get a good side. They've got a big waterfall and big pools to play around in, and there's lots of them there. They looked really happy.
Yeah, well, it's reasonably comfortable, I suppose, this place, but, I mean, I've been in more comfortable rooms, yes.
If you try to compare the situations and the environment that you live here with the environment that you live in Brazil, there is a big difference. Here, you live in a very small place with all the technological advances possible. You have everything sorted out, double glazing, you know, your heating and everything in Brazil, but you don't have space. In Brazil, you have space. Although you don't have all this technological, you know, double glaze and things like that, and you know, but you have space. And we need space to live. We need space to feel that we are part of the world and not a kind of piece of object in a box.
My room is a bit too small, really, and I've got so much stuff in it that if I get anything new, there's just nowhere to put it.
Well, sometimes you can't get out and about as much as you would like to. You're stuck in for some reason, like I'm stuck in today. And then, yes, you get bored and you get fed up with looking at the same four walls.
I try to spend as little time in here as possible, but I can't actually get out and about. I sort of escape into books and things.
I feel very secure. And well looked after, very well looked after, and I'm not worried about anything. I know whatever happens, they'll look after me and put me where I ought to be.
I think they like it in the wild, if they were in the wild, but I think it's much better to be in bars, because, like I've said, they get fed, whereas some animals, they go for days without food.
Because the animals that are in the circus have to get on boxes and balls, but animals in the zoo, they don't have to do anything. They can do their own things, like drinking and eating.
I miss a lot of the food. I miss the fresh meat, you know, because in Brazil we are predominantly carnivores. We are not, you know, vegetarian, and we don't like potatoes, we like meat. And we like a fresh meat.
My favourite food is, I'm afraid to say, is steak. I go a long way to go and get a nice steak.
Do you like lions as well, then? Do you like steak jam chips with lions with it?
Not with lions, Andrew, no. I don't like lion steak. I prefer the ordinary steak.
I'd like to live somewhere a bit hotter. I don't like getting rained on, and I don't like being cold. And I find that here I often get rained on and I'm often cold.
Where I would like to live and to spend most of my life? In a hot country. You know, in a hot country that I have a good weather and that I have space, that I have trees, you know? That I don't have only grass with pollens that give me hay fever every day. I need a space with blue skies without that I can see the sun every day. All right, that I have nice weather, that I can just have nice water, you know, to dive, to swimming. It means a tropical country, not in an island, a cold one. It's easy. Any part of the world, but hot. Name it, and there you go.
No.
No, 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 no,